Okay, so today we're going to be making some little tea light holders out of these Banksia nuts. Banksia nut I've not really used before, but they're these little nuts. I've just cut the ends off so that I can mount them between centres, and then I'm going to cut a little tenon in this one, turn it around, and then I'm going to make a hole in the end so I can fit in one of these little tea light holders. They're about 10 for £2 from IKEA. Okay. Right, so I've got my Banksia nut mounted between centres. Just take my wedding ring off for safety. Now, they contain little seeds inside these little holes here, so it is important that you stand well out of the way when you first turn it on, because they just flick out like little projectiles, and I should imagine they hurt. So I'm just gonna, with variable speed, just turn it up slowly. So just turn it up to about 2,000 revs.
Put the gas mask on for safety. Put the ruffing guard. Make a little shoulder. Stop that, so we've just made a little tenon to grip onto so that we can just mount that in the jaws and then turn it around.
Okay, so the Banksia nut is mounted on the chuck. I'm just going to clean up the end here, make that flat, and then I'm going to use a couple of Forstner bits to drill a hole in that will accept, and then just widen that out so it'll accept the little holder.
I'll put gloves on this time, just because there's a lot more going on and it's just a bit safer.
Okay, so the end's been cleaned up now, reasonably straight, reasonably flat. So what I'm going to do now is replace the revolving centre for a Jacob's chuck. Then I'm going to put Forstner bit in. I'm going to start off with a small one just to make a smaller hole, and then I'll just widen it out. It's just slightly less stress on the wood that way. Okay, so I've just bored a smaller hole, and now I've got my large Forstner bit in. It's a 38mm bit. It's just slightly smaller than this little dish, if you can see here. So I'm going to bore the hole that's about the right depth for the dish. and then I'm just going to use my square carbide tool here just to make the hole a little bit bigger so that this will fit in, and then when it's all finished I'll epoxy that in so it won't come out. So I've got the hole bored in the middle here now, so I'm just going to widen it out, make it the right size and depth for the tea light holder. We'll just ramp the speed up. About 1800 revs. Take a little tea light holder and just try it in. Not quite big enough. You just want to make it a little bit bigger. Just move the tool rest in a bit closer just to give me a little bit more stability as I'm going in. It's not a deep hole, but all helps.
Okay, so we've got the hole hollowed out. I'm just going to give it a quick sand around the top and in the hole just to smooth it out, and then I'm going to finish with a bit of wax, bit of beeswax, and I'm going to part it off, and then I'll turn it around, refit it in the hole, and then I'll polish the bottom off. I'm starting off with some 180.
Okay, so I'm just going to apply a bit of beeswax polish. It's fairly simple, I just like using it. It may get stuck in these little holes here, which could be interesting, but then I'll just use a toothbrush or something to get that out later. Some people use beeswax, some will use microcrystalline. I do use it, I use that mainly on pens. But for this, I'm just going to use some simple beeswax because it's just nice and easy. So I'm just going to take a little cloth, just a bit of blue Kim towel, and I'm just going to wipe the wax on. Yeah, you can see it's already just sort of catching in the little holes. So I'm just going to wipe the wax in, wipe the wax on. I've sanded this to 240 grit, by the way. Some people sand it finer, some won't. 240 I find for just small little ornamental things like this is usually fine, especially when you're going to put a wax polish on, because it usually comes up to nice high shine anyway. And then I'm just going to turn it on. Just going to leave it for a few seconds just to fling out any loose wax. Now I'm just going to use a dry part of the cloth, keeping your hands well away because there are some sharp edges in there. Give it a bit of a buff. And then same inside, just put the cloth in, give it a bit of a buff. This is coming out to a nice polish. And I'm just going to put a finger wrapped in some cloth in. Now you can get special wood turner's cloth. It is good, I have used it before. Supposedly it's safer than using regular cloth. But for what I'm doing, this is fine because this rips anyway if it catches. You can see there's all little bits on ripped anyway. So just leave that on to dry for a sec. And then I'm just going to take a little fingerful again. And this time I'm going to have the lathe running. And I'm just going to keep my finger on. And same again, just another bit of polish. Just right in the middle there. And clean bit of the cloth. Just really buff it up to a nice shine. That's going to look nice. Okay, so that's all buffed, ready to part off. Okay, so we'll just give that a little bit of a twizzle by hand. Okay, done. So we're just going to part this off now. So we've got that's that. Just a thin little nub, and normally what I do now is I'll just take one of these little flush cut saws, just find it easier. I can just put that in the hole there and then just saw off. There we go. So you can see the little wax is still in there, so I'm going to clean that out shortly, and then I'll just clean up the bottom, and then that'll be able to sit flush once I've cleaned the bottom up, and then we'll epoxy the holder in. Right, so we've changed the jaws and the chuck again. We've reversed the bit of Banksia nut onto the jaws. So we're just going to clean up the bottom, give it a quick sand, and then we'll be ready to give that a bit of polish, and then it's all done. I'm just going to use spindle gouge, 3/8 or half inch, I'm not sure, I can't remember off the top of my head. And we're just going to clean it up, that's a little bit high. Thank you.